then what is? That is the question that we are asking, sir. And we spoke about it, but I know you'll have to go shortly. I want to shift my focus now to China. What's happening at the LAC? The MEA said that there is an agreement that's been reached between India and China. In fact, S. Jaishankar also spoke to a private network, and he said that the disengagement has been completed, and now Indian forces can patrol all those areas which were not, that was not done earlier after the Galwan clashes. How do you see this development?
Well, it's a very welcome development, and if it actually happens on the ground, it will be a very, very great step in the improvement of India's relations with China. But as I said, we have to see what happens on the ground. And that verification can only be done by the armed forces, because they are there at the border. The Chinese may say, and actually they may do it, but at the same time, they may not do as they promised to do. This has been quite a history in the sort of pattern of their behavior. So we'll have to see how the armed forces report back to us on what is happening at the border, whether their patrolling rights have been restored to what they were before the these tensions arose. So I will look forward to hearing from the armed forces what they say is the on-ground situation. But if it has happened, and if there is a genuine need which the Chinese have felt for de-escalation, then it's very good.
Right. And the minister also said that it is a result of a patient diplomacy that was done over the last few years. There have been 31 officials from Government of India and officials from China holding talks on this matter. And there have been 21 core commander level meetings that have taken place. And it's a result of those hectic meetings that happened that they have reached this conclusion and this agreement that the disengagement process is underway or has completed. But and it could possibly lead to disengagement also in the future. But the point is that can Chinese be trusted? As you say that in the past also there have been agreements. It is not the first time that there is an agreement between China and India. In the past, it's happened many times. But what happens? After some time passes, the Chinese come in, they occupy areas, and there is this concept of salami slicing. They go away, they go back, but they don't go back fully. Some of the area they keep with them. And that is the pattern that we've seen in the past. Will that repeat, or there is a reason to be more optimistic this time?
Well, you know, where the Chinese are concerned, I tend to be very careful as regards believing their statements. If what they have said is true, then it's very good. But you know, the timing of the entire thing makes me a little suspicious. The Chinese have said it on the eve of the BRICS summit, which is taking place from today in Russia. And it seems that because of the fact that the Chinese have an interest in strengthening BRICS, because they see it as an organization which challenges Western supremacy. Because of this reason, the Chinese may be wanting that the atmosphere at the BRICS summit remains non-confrontational, and that everything is smooth in terms of the events that happen in the summit itself. So, as I said, I remain a little suspicious of the reality of what the Chinese are saying. In other words, whether they are saying will actually happen on the ground, will translate into on-ground activity. Because, as I said, the timing is very significant, and that creates some suspicion in my mind.
Yes, it's happened just before the BRICS summit. So obviously the two cannot be looked in isolation. There is obviously a definite connection between the two, but a positive development, as has been seen said by everybody. They're looking at it with caution, though. But will it also impact relations on other counts, like on economic counts, on other exchange between the two countries? Will it help to improve relations further? What happened in Galwan was clearly something that put brakes on the relation on multiple levels. Will that change slowly now, if at all this thing works out on the ground, that Indian forces are able to patrol, there is a disengagement that's taken place, and ultimately this will lead to de-escalation? Will that happen?
Well, it's certainly a very positive development, because we have been wanting de-escalation at the border, at the line of actual control. Yeah. Now, I may mention that the Chinese also perhaps feel that there is a need to de-escalate, because their economic interests are being affected. The Chinese economy is not doing so well in recent months, and their exports are reportedly slumping. So they feel that they could do with a better relationship with India. And therefore, as I said, there could be some motives behind what the Chinese are doing. They have interests involved. But certainly, a de-escalation would be in our interest. And if relations with China can move towards normalization, in the sense that they can be restored to the situation before the Galwan clashes broke out, then certainly it is something that we would be happy with.
Yes, and we'll be looking forward to that. What happens here on, obviously, an exercise has completed, an agreement has reached, but will it be implemented on the ground? That will be closely followed. But thanks so much, Prabhudayalji, for joining us today and for sharing your thoughts on a wide range of issues. We'll, of course, keep a track on all those stories. But thanks so much for joining us. And thanks to all the audiences for watching the Bhuju story.
It's great to see you here. Thank you for watching our work. If you haven't subscribed yet, don't forget to click the bell icon and subscribe to Bhuju Story and support independent, robust journalism.